Hi friends, in this video let us discuss how to draw different diagrams for our presentation or maybe thesis or for textbook preparation and so many things. So how to draw the figures, technical figures, maybe circuit diagrams, block diagrams and so many other figures. So let us see how this will be done by using Visio software. First I will open a Visio one file. So this is my Visio drawing file, Microsoft Office Visio drawing. So I will open this file so that you can come to know how to proceed. Here engineering is there, so in general engineering is used for, but it is useful for so many things. Business is also there, we can use it for business, we can use it for engineering, we can use it for flowcharts, we can use it for general purpose like this, and we can use it for maps and floor plans like this, how the planning will be. We can use it for networking, how the different computers are connected, or how the house is connected to some network things, and scheduling, calendars, how to use it, maybe some metric, this is US units. So the like this different things are available in this Visio drawing. This is software and database, so for regarding software and database also we can draw some figures. For as per my application is concerned, so I am an electrical engineer, so I want to take electrical things here. So first let me go to engineering. This is basic electrical and it is in metric. So let me open this. If I open this, this thing will be like this, and this is a open page, and these are the fundamental items in metric, and the second one is qualifying symbols in metric. Some symbols are available, semiconductor and electronic symbols are also available, switches and relays are available, transmission paths are available. In general, let us see the fundamental items. The fundamental items are ground, maybe resistance, resistor, capacitor, antenna, crystal, fuse, and all these things are available. See, these are the things available for us, and we can take any one of them. Let me take inductor here. If you press the control, and if you can scroll button in mouse to upward so that it will be zoomed like this. Yeah, this is the inductor. So if I want to connect it properly, I need to reduce this thing to this, and I can connect like this to anything I want to connect. Yeah, this is the connector. But as per my knowledge is concerned, it's very easy if you go ahead with these drawing things only. So with these drawing things, it's very easy. We can connect whatever we want simply, but this type of things cannot be, maybe for inductor, it's better to take from this, as this is very nice compared to this. We can also do with this thing or this thing, but it will take much time and it may not be accurate. So we can take this. And there is one thing called connector. This is the connector tool. If you have two things, for example, let me copy this and paste this, or I can drag it like this. No, it will not come. So copy and paste, and one more thing I will paste. Yeah, if I have two things like this, now with this connector I can easily connect like this. This is electrical connection, so this is a normal connection. So better to go ahead with normal connection only. So electrical connection is, this is something, some predefined things will be there in this, but here there is no predefined, so whatever we want we can connect it. So this is the thing. Now I like to show you how to make a small circuit with DC source. So let me take this, I can draw like this, and it's a DC source, so the symbol will be like this, and this will be like this. And I want to connect two resistors. Let me take a resistor from this part. This is one resistor, and let me see the other resistor also. Let me copy this and paste this, and I can turn like this. Yeah, I want to do like this. Okay, this is my circuit, and I am simply connecting these two. Yeah, let me click here so that it will come as a turn, and let me click here so that it will turn as a, it will come as a turn over. So this is the, this is my entire circuit. So this is the circuit what I have. Now I like to do something different. It means this is circuit, so I want to give 10 volt of DC source. So let me write the same thing in text box. 10 volt, 10 V of DC source, and this is the resistance. Let me take it as R1. Okay, let me make it into subscript R1, and then I need to go ahead. Okay, let me do this. R1 is equal to, it is 5 ohm. I want to make it into 5 ohm, so it will be like this. Or I can directly take the symbol also. Here I need to go to edit, insert symbol. Everything is just like MS Word only. Okay, everything is available. Some extra features also available. Those things you can trace out to whenever it is required, you can use them. So this is ohm. So I, let me insert this. Yeah, ohm has been inserted here. And same thing I like to show you. The same thing can be written for this one also. Okay, let us take this one also 5 ohm, and this is 5 ohm, this is 5 ohm. So this, these things will be like this. So let me take, select, and yeah, this is subscript and this is also subscript. So to make it subscript, we need to press shift and left arrow so that the particular part will be selected, and then we need to press control and plus so that it will be subscripted. If you want to make this as superscript, you need to do again, you need to do just select the part which part is superscripted and press alt control and then plus. Okay, this command is not working out here. Maybe this will be worked out for presentation PPT, and also in the that what we call as for in Word also it will be worked out. But let us take, we want only subscript here. So let me do like this. So this is the thing, this is R2. Yeah, now I like to show you the things from this point onwards, how to edit this. Now I want the thing should be thicker and it should be good format. Let me go to format first. Text, line, fill, everything is available. Let me go ahead with line. Yeah, this is the line. So pattern is same. Let me continue the same pattern. That means straight lines, there is dotted lines, I mean dashed lines, and then dotted lines, dotted line and dashed line, one dash and two dots, like this. Some different patterns are available here. You can see which pattern do you like. Okay, this is the thing. So let me take it as first pattern, and the, my weight should be 5, so that I want to make it bold. And if you want to take some arrows, you can take arrows here. Here begin arrows should, arrows can also be added by using this from begin, and this is at the end. Similarly, you can make bigger size, small size, everything will be available. These things are for arrows, line ends. Okay, then if you want to turn, you can turn like this. So all, everything is available. You just see and just get the things and apply. Okay, apply and okay. So everything will be like this. Otherwise, let me remove this, it's not looking good. So let me remove this part. This should be like this. Apply. Okay. Yeah, these are the things. Yes, we have all, everything was selected. So this has come for this also. So we can remove this straight away. Let me go to format line. There is no line for this. Let me go to this and none. If apply so that line will be removed. Here also line will be removed. Let me remove the line and make it clear. Apply. Okay. And this also apply. Line. No line is required for this. So let me apply this and okay. So this is the thing, and now we can go ahead with colors also. You can fill this with some colors, maybe red color. Let me take it as red. So this one will be there. So you can remove this and you can put this. Yeah, otherwise you can directly see this fill, solid fill. If you make it redding, it will be like this. Okay, actually this is not applicable. That's all. Yeah, if I like to change this color can be changed like this. Go to format, line, and then here the color is black, so I can change it to red or something else. Apply and okay. See, this will be changed. Similarly here also I can change this to some green. Okay, let this may be green. Yeah. So this is the thing. So you can change the colors also. Here also you can change the color, as everything is almost the same. So you can change color here. Let me take blue color here. Okay. This is a line. Here we haven't taken any line. So let's remove this line. Yeah. This commander text box. So in text you can change the color if you want. Format text. Yeah, this color may be changed to something, some blue. Apply and okay. So it will be like this. So like this you can make it bold, and you can change the color, and you can write something, you can insert something just like MS Word. So this is a very good software for drawing the pictures. Now I like to show you how these pictures can be saved. Simply, if you go to file, it will be written as save as, and once save as has been clicked, yeah, there so many thing options will be there. Let me take to desktop, and this will be maybe something KSHORE. Yeah, here you have to see so many options. This is .vst. This is the drawing file, so that whenever you can open this, you can change it whatever you can. So this is also very important file. So you need to save one file like this, and all other files I no need of saving anything. And you have to save .jpg if you want a picture, I mean if you want an image, so that the image can be used in anywhere. That is one thing. The second point is TIF form is very very important. Let me show the difference between JPG and TIF in the next video, and why TIF is very important compared to JPG form. Okay, these two forms are picture forms, I mean image forms only. So you can directly use in your Word file or there also in presentations, PPTs also. But as per TIF is concerned, for LaTeX it won't agree TIF, it will only see JPG formats only. So where JPG is useful and TIF is not useful for LaTeX, but as per normal thing is concerned, TIF is very good compared to JPG, as TIF will give you better clarity, I mean whole clarity. That means if you zoom the paper also, once the paper was published, if you zoom the paper also, the picture is clarity will not go out. But in JPG the picture clarity will go out if you zoom the thing or if you zoom the image. That's the thing. So let me save this in TIF only. Just save. Yeah, I have saved it. You need to customize this. 120 by 120 is also okay. 300 by 300 is good thing. So you can press okay. So if you like this video, please like it. If you want to share this video, please share with your friends. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.